Welcome back. In this video and the next video, I want to be more concrete. So I want to show you some examples of calculating eigenvalues and eigenvectors for some given 2x2 matrices. Here we're looking at the simple matrix given by big A, which is 0, 1, 1, 0. It's a symmetric matrix, which turns out that all symmetric matrices have real eigenvalues. So the eigenvalues for this matrix will be real. We want to solve the eigenvalue problem, so we want to solve Ax equals lambda x for the eigenvalues lambda and their associated eigenvectors x. This is the same equation. So if we have an I here, we introduce an I, this is the equation A minus lambda I times x equals 0. This will turn out to be the equation we use to compute the eigenvectors, but we know that the equation we use to compute the eigenvalues is the characteristic equation, that the determinant of this matrix must be 0. So we have the determinant of A minus lambda I must be equal to 0. And what is that? That's the determinant. We subtract lambda from the diagonal, so lambda 1, 1 minus lambda, 1, 1 minus lambda, subtracting lambda from the diagonal. The determinant of this matrix then is lambda squared minus 1, and this is supposed to be 0, right? So we have lambda squared minus 1 equals 0. So we have lambda squared has to be plus 1. That's a very simple quadratic equation. That has roots lambda equals minus 1 and lambda equals plus 1. So we have two eigenvalues, lambda 1 equal to minus 1 and lambda 2 equal to plus 1. Okay. So this matrix A, 0, 1, 1, 0, has two eigenvalues, minus 1 and plus 1. We want to find the eigenvectors. So each eigenvalue has an associated eigenvector. So how do we find the eigenvector? So if we start with lambda 1 equals minus 1, we go back to this A minus lambda I x equals 0. Now we're looking for the x associated with lambda equal to lambda 1. So the equation we want to solve is A minus lambda 1 I, and the eigenvector here would be x1 equal to 0. So this is the equation for the eigenvector. Lambda 1 is equal to minus 1, so this means A plus I, we add 1 plus 1 to the diagonal elements of A. So this is a matrix equation. I can write that as A plus I. Here's our A. So I'm adding 1 to the diagonal elements. So 1, 1, 1, 1. That's A plus I, right? Times x1. Let me call x1 here. I'm going to call v1, v2. So these are the components of x1. And this is supposed to be 0. So remember, 0 is a special symbol that can be a matrix or a scalar. Here, of course, it's a column vector, right? So that's our 0. So this is two equations, right? V1 plus V2 equals 0. And V1 plus V2 equals 0. So actually, the second equation is exactly the same as the first equation. That's always true. The second equation is always just a multiple of the first equation for the 2x2 case, because this matrix is not an invertible matrix, right? Remember, A minus lambda I is not an invertible matrix. So we get V1 plus V2 equals 0, which tells us that the second component is equal to the negative of the first component. Okay, so that's for the eigenvector. So let me just leave that like this, and then we'll write down explicitly the eigenvector at the end. Okay, that's the first eigenvalue. The second eigenvalue, lambda 2, equals 1. The same equation, right? This time we have a minus lambda 2i times the second eigenvector is equal to 0. This matrix equation tells us lambda 2 is 1, so that means a minus I, so we subtract 1 from the diagonal elements of A. So we get minus 1, 1, 1, minus 1, times the eigenvector. Let me just reuse the symbol V1 and V2, okay, even though they have different values here. But for simplicity, I'll just reuse those symbols. And that's supposed to be equal to 0. So here, the first equation is minus V1 plus V2 equals 0. The second equation is V1 minus V2 equals 0. The second equation is just the negative of the first equation. So again, doesn't add any additional information. That has to do with the fact that the determinant of this matrix is 0. So then what is the first equation? We can start with the first. So minus V1 plus V2 equals 0. And here we can solve for V2. So here V2 is equal to V1. Okay? All right. So this gives us the eigenvectors, and we have the eigenvalues. I can put this together. So let me put it down here. We have for the first eigenvalue, lambda 1 equals negative 1. And then for the first eigenvector, x1, the eigenvector associated with lambda 1 satisfies v2 equals minus v1. So we have a freedom of a constant here, because ax equals lambda x. If we multiply x by a constant, we still have a times cx equals lambda times cx, still the same equation. So the eigenvector is only determined up to a constant, okay? That means we can normalize the eigenvector. Sometimes we're going to want to normalize it so the norm is 1. In this case, it doesn't matter. So in this case, what I want to do is to set just v1 equal to 1. Okay, so that's the simplest thing to do. So V1 is equal to 1, then V2 is equal to negative 1. And that's the eigenvector. And then the second eigenvalue, lambda 2 equals plus 1, we get x2 then, comes from here, V2 is equal to V1. So here I can set V1 equal to 1, and then V2 is the same, so is also 1. Okay, you can try this. You can take A, you can multiply by x1. You should get negative 1 times x1. So A times 1 minus 1 should give you minus 1, 1. And A times 1, 1 should give you 1, 1, because lambda 2 equals 1. Okay, so what have we done? We considered a symmetric matrix, A, 0, 1, 1, 0. Symmetric matrices can be proven to have only real eigenvalues. So we work the eigenvalue problem, ax equals lambda x. We find the eigenvalues. There are two eigenvalues, minus 1 and 1. Then we go back to the equation, a minus lambda I x equals 0. Plug in the two values of lambda, which I do here. Lambda 1 equals minus 1, and lambda 2 equals 1. That gives us a matrix equation. In the 2x2 case, only one equation is linearly independent. And that's this equation, V1 plus V2 equals 0. So V2 equals minus V1. And in this one, it's minus V1 plus V2 equals 0, or V2 equals V1. And that gives us then our eigenvalues and our eigenvectors. The eigenvectors are free to choose up to multiplication by a constant. And here I normalized it so the first component is equal to 1. But you're free to do what you like. That's it. Next video, we'll do another example. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.